Vapor. Have you ever done a carving?
No, sir. I've never done any wood carving, but...
Never tried a chisel?
Never tried a
because
chisel.
Because I was about to say, okay, grab a chisel and do what I am doing.
Oh, I'm glad practice. You didn't. I have no experience whatsoever.
Okay. So I won't give it to you because you will feel terrible.
Yes, I will be terrible.
That's okay.
But after seeing your work, I like to try it. Maybe eventually. It's
believe
so beautiful.
Me, if you like it, you'll do it. Now this is on top, these two is on top, and on the bottom, opposite to this, top, and bottom, here is bottom, and top, bottom, and top. It's coming the same here than there. Yep. Having fun.
Yeah.
I got you $5. Some chisels are 50 years old. This one, no. This is Swiss. The Americans made, let me see. This one is American made in New York. manufacturer was there. This one is at least 55 years old. This one, look at the handle, it's all cracked already. And I have another, like four or five of those years. Then I start buying the Swiss. No, this is English. This is made in England. For you? You want to learn this?
Just for art in general, what is?
If you like it, go ahead. Sketch. Once you dominate the sketch, you can do carving. Because as I told you a few minutes ago, carving is three-dimensional sketch. Whatever you can sketch, you can carve. Simple as that. Yeah. And masters are made out of practice. Right. I started as an apprentice in that picture frame factory in New York City in 1962. And I didn't serious carving in my life. I didn't know a chisel, only my pocket knife.
Right.
So when I went over there, the owner asked me, do you know how to do carving? So I say, honest to God, no. I don't know how to do it, but I promise you, I learned quickly. So he said, okay, I'm gonna put test. So he gave me one sample of a picture frame about 16 inches of a piece of, and I still remember the carving that he asked me to do. It was, a piece of wood like this. 3 hours later, he came along. Okay, George, let me see what you did. Pick out a piece of wood. Awful. I didn't know what I did. It was, I just killed that poor piece of wood. So he said, the sketch is perfect, but the chisel is terrible. You get the job, because I know you want to learn. I started as an apprentice. 6 months later, I was the foreman of 10 guys producing picture frames by the dozens. That line is at the level that should be.
Yes.
Down there. Okay. Now flour.
Yes.
Let's come with the flour.
Has any of your work been in museums?
What?
Has your work been in any museums?
Not yet. Oh, I just finished an eagle that I know is going to be in a museum. You haven't seen that eagle?
I'm not sure. Was it in the book?
Not yet.
Okay.
It's in the bigger book. I'll show it to you once we go upstairs.
Okay, yes, yes.
It's a fish eagle. She's holding this salmon fish with the talons, and it's pulling out of the water with a splash of water on the base, and then the two wings up, ready to slam down.
Yeah.
Oh, the sketch is here. I gave him one day the keys of my chop. He used my chop to do his funny enjoyment. Do craziness in wood and he enjoys so much. But the funny thing is one day, it was Saturday afternoon, me and my wife needed something for my chop, and I told her, let's go to the chop and pick up something that I need. So, okay, let's go. When we approached the chop, I saw all doors open. What? I left open last night. Nothing, nobody was around. The gate door was totally open. Get out of my car, we enter, and there was Father Romana, sitting in the middle, in a little stool, sweating like crazy. That crazy guy cleaned the whole shop, all the chairs, all the tools, put everything in his place, my office. Oh my God, so Father, what are you doing? Oh, I thought I would give you a hand to clean this because I have nothing to do today. He said, Father, you have no health to do that. I need the exercise. It's good for me. I need to sweat too. He cleaned the whole place. I asked him, Father, what is it with wood? You love wood. I love wood. What the hell is it? The thing with wood, he said, don't ask me. Ask Jesus. What do you mean, ask Jesus? Yes, ask him. He spent 33 years living in this planet and preached only for 3 years what he did in the other 30 years, carpenter with his father. Oh, that's right. Wood. Yes, wood. So it's appealing. If he like wood that much, must be something wood in wood.
Yeah.
See? He was right. 33 years in this world, and preached only for 3 and died. But the other 30 years, he was woodworker. That one is separated from the whole thing. Now I'm going to do this corner.
Okay.
But this one doesn't make a difference. Let's see what happens. Let's start by the flower. Yes. Okay.
So Mr. Posada, what's your favorite medium to use?
For painting or for carving?
Anything. Do you like... What's your favorite, woodworking or painting?
Both.
You love them both?
Both. In woodworking, it's more business than in wood paint, in oil painting. Because painting, everybody does.
Mm-hmm.
And our galleries are full of beautiful masterpieces. Mm-hmm. Nobody look at them anymore. Because the taste for oil painting changed too much.
Yeah.
So whatever you can do, could be a masterpiece. Some people could say that's beautiful, others say that's ugly. A camera do that. I don't like that. Too modern, too classic. You never know. But in this kind of work, I have no competition.
Right.
I have not a single person that do all this that I can do. So I feel happy. I love it. Yes. Yeah.